Let's make a contribution to Lichess and take a look at the new Gitpod configuration. First, we'll click the link that will start a new Gitpod instance, and this creates a remote development environment, and you access it via your browser. So Gitpod is creating a virtual environment with all of the services necessary to run Lichess, and you'll get an in-browser code editor that you can use too. So you don't need to have anything except a web browser to contribute. Everything will start automatically. This is the terminal where the startup script runs. You get a prompt asking which optional services you want to run. Depending on what you're working on, you just select which ones you want and it will start up those containers. Now it's cloning the repos and starting the containers. This takes about 10 minutes. Once it's done, as part of the default setup, we get three sites available to us. First is our Lichess development site. It has test data in it, so we can log in as one of the test users. Second is MailPit, which intercepts any outbound emails and will show them in this inbox for debugging. And third is Mongo Express, which lets us look into the database in case we need to see schema or data, which can be helpful in debugging. Let's see how we can use this to make a contribution to Lichess. I was reviewing the new user signup flow and noticed some things we could probably improve. A new user has to confirm their email address, but when they click the link in the email, there's no confirmation that it worked. So let's see if we can fix that. Back in our code editor, we're gonna edit the Lila repo. So open repo/Lila. And to figure out where we need to look, we'll search for the route. And that gives us which controller method it calls. And in that, we see that it calls redirect new user, which is defined right here. And that returns the redirect. Lila has the ability to do flash messages, which add data to the session to appear on the next page load. And some redirects already use that, so let's borrow from those. And we can give it a custom success message. So we modified a backend file, so we have to restart Lila, and let's test it out. This time we'll create a new user, we'll verify our email, and we see the flash message, so it worked. Let's just make sure our code is formatted correctly and ready to submit as a pull request. I'll create a branch for my changes, commit the changes, and then push them to my fork. And finally, I can submit the change as a pull request. I'll add a screenshot so others can see what it does, and maybe this will get accepted into the Lichess codebase.